Hello, everyone, and welcome back. We're back again.
Hi.
Yay. So I will say, Storm here.
Mom here.
Tom here.
Kimmy here.
Yay, guys. Yay. The Brady Bunch. We have a big family. Can you imagine if we got all the siblings together, let alone cousins? Like, how big would that be? But just you know, our main family. Just the siblings alone. We have a lot of siblings, so that would be the Brady Bunch. So this is cool. Changed up the grid a little bit. And we're going to be watching Ghostbusters 2 today.
Great.
So happy Halloween. It's been a long time because we saw Ghostbusters, the first one, last year. You guys were blind to it, so that was fun. Mm-hmm. I did see parts of it before. And this one, I think I did see a lot more than that because I do remember a lot of scenes from this that I thought were in the first one, but I think it's in this one. But I don't want to tell you what they are. So you know the basis of the story. Like, you know, like, what happened in the first one. Yes. So I don't really have to explain anything. I don't want to spoil anything for you. Tom isn't blind, though. You saw this. We probably saw it together. So Tom and I are twins. Can't you tell, guys? Where's your fun hat?
How would I know? You're so good looking.
I know. This is so great. I'm so happy to have all of us together right now. This is so cool. So I'm going to keep saying, because Tom's new to the channel, but we've been trying to get him on the channel for a long time. And ever since we started doing Zoom, as bad as this year is with the pandemic, like, it changed our style and how to react, at least temporarily, you know, because we thought we were only going to be doing this for a couple weeks at, you know, tops. And now we're actually doing it for maybe a year, just to be safe and everything. And Tom lives in Florida, so heck, now, like, we can bring anyone on here, and I just love it how we can actually bring Tommy. So yay Tom.
Excellent.
So it's really cool we can connect more this way. Even though we do call and all that, it's more consistent to do it this way. You know. But Ghostbusters, so favorite character that stands out to you, do you remember? I know it's been a year now. Last Halloween we saw the first one. I always
Peter Venkman has always
been like the main, right? I always liked, remember Egon. When I was a kid, I always had a crush on Ray and Egon, the cartoon. I was like the nerdy people and the ones that are just like really nice and nerdy.
That's right.
But Peter Venkman was always like the big character, was always like a main character.
He was
always like the outgoing one who was always good with the ladies and would always get into trouble.
Center of attraction.
That's right. Yes.
So, and I love Sigourney Weaver. She's always great. I love her. Yeah. As Dana, she was great. And they did get together at the end of the first one, right?
Yes, they did.
And so that was fun. And then, Tom, you got to show your shirt because I keep looking at that shirt. He is a fan, guys.
Okay.
Zool. There is only Zool. That is perfect. I love it. And I think of, again, talking about Family Guy, I was just thinking Family Guy with, like, there's only Zool or something. Remember Peter Griffin? That was so funny. I was, like, dying when he did that. I bought this at Walmart for $2 and something, and I love this freaking one. I was like, and Slimer was huge too. I know.
Oh, Slimer! Oh God, he just slimed everything.
I know. Like, Slimer was a big deal in the cartoon, and he was a main character in the first movie. Who was just a blunder. He was mischievous.
That's right.
He was the first ghost they caught.
He was. Yep. So I don't know if he makes an appearance in this one or not. I don't remember much, but we'll see. So shall we just get into it?
Yes, I love it.
Look at this picture. Ooh.
I love Bill Murray.
Bill Murray's awesome.
Bill freaking Murray.
Oh, I love that Zombieland. We actually really enjoyed Zombieland a lot.
That's good,
I really didn't think they were going to like it, but it was so good. Like,
remember when we went to Universal last year and we saw the Bill Murray act?
That was amazing. Yeah, so when we went to Universal Studios last year, we had a ball. Like,
it was for the Halloween
first time going, Halloween Horror Nights, and we had the best time. The theme was Zombieland, and they deck it out. You can go on rides, and they shut down a few, but a lot of them were open, actors that resembled the characters. and they did a really good job. So we had a character that looked like Bill Murray dressed as a zombie in the crowds, oh, and he was pretending to act like a zombie. And then you had other employees like actually as zombies, but they were very believable and freaky, and they can't touch you, but they get really close and they see who's like the most scared and follow them. So don't make yourself a target. Yeah. So if you start screaming, they tend to follow those people. And they get really creepy because their mannerisms are so real and how they do it. Because you know they had a lot of training and they love what they do. Most of them, you can tell they love what they do. And they had a Bill Murray. And I was like, it's Bill Murray. And he came up to me and he goes, no, shh. Goes, don't tell him that. Because right when I said that, there were three other zombies and they all of a sudden perked up and looked because they're all looking for Bill Murray. And he's like, don't tell them that. They can't know. And I was like, oh, and he's like, yeah, they had Columbus. And he was, like, nerdy and just, like, you know, like, with a bat. Yeah. And he was all lanky and stuff. And he's running around. And the zombies were chasing him. Oh, so it was really fun. Like, we had the best time. Fun, yeah. Blaring music. So that was a lot of fun. I would totally do it again. And the haunted houses were amazing. They had a Stranger Things one that year.
Oh, they had a Ghostbuster one last year, too.
And they had a Ghostbuster one. See, I really, we got so tired. And we should have got the Fast Pass or whatever they call it there. Instead
Express Pass.
Instead of getting the normal, because the lines were so long, you know, and we wanted to go to more haunted houses, and a few waits were like an hour to 2 hours, and we're like, because the night is how
by
long?
By that time, the night's over.
Yeah, because it starts around 6-7 o'clock, right, and then it goes on till like 11 midnight maybe, so it just flies by. But it's really worth it. I thought it was fun, and we should totally do that one year.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. All right, guys, you ready?
Ready.
Ghostbusters 2.
It's an old-time carriage for that time.
Boy, he's mad.
Yeah. Oh, my. Oh. Watch out. The baby.
Oh, my goodness. Yoo-hoo.
The baby.
That would be so terrifying.
Oh, my
God.
I love Ecto-1.
Yeah, it's so cool. We saw that at Otakon. It looked just like that too.
That's right, yeah.
Good job.
It suits me in the more important restoration.
Yeah,
I had a feeling. I had a feeling. Ooh. Oh, look at that. Ooh.
Oh, interesting.
Ooh, he's watching you.
That's actually really well done too. That's scary.
Yeah.
That is.
Hello,
Dana.
It's like a soap opera.
It's so dramatic.
Male Caucasian.
Approximately 24 inches. Aww, look at him. What's that? The poor little thing.
You know, you've been better off here.
Oh,
named after a hot dog, you poor man.
Oh my God.
That's such a freaky painting.
Oh,
God. Now you have lightning powers.
Find me a child.
Oh, look at the ooze in the background.
Oh, child. No.
Child?
Dana's child.
Ooh.
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 Whoa.
It's a river of slime!
Ew.
Ew.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
Like slime sharks.
Get
him up.
Oh, there he is.
Ah, great.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God.
Because one time I turned into a dog and they helped me. Thank you.
Tom shirt.
Oh, boy.
We're going to pay fines in the amount of $25,000 each. We sent you to 18 months in the city correctional facility.
Whoa.
The Rikers are banned.
Whoa! Whoa! Ghost came out!
Whoa!
Ray!
Ray! Egon!
Winston!
Those are heavy wooden chairs.
My God! Whoa!
Don't cross!
Ooh!
Woohoo!
Yay!
Itty bitty living space. Oh, there he is.
There he is, Slimer.
We've been running tests to see if we can get an equally strong positive reaction.
You're not sleeping with it, are you, right?
Yes! Maybe really sleeping.
Your kinetic test.
Okay. What? Okay, leave that a mystery, I guess. That's weird.
Ooh, the slime. Oh, no.
Better call the maintenance. Stuff. Ooh, this looks like an intestine.
Ooh, yeah, it does.
It does. Yeah.
Ooh, broke the
tongue. Whoa, way. Whoa.
It's alive.
Yeah, I guess it is. Ooh, that's scary.
That's the river of slime.
What? Whoa, can I get out of here? Woo!
Oh. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, a lot of them!
Oops, behind you.
It's an old steam locomotive.
Yeah. Oh, movement spin! Oh, oh, thank goodness!
Oh my god.
Ray? Ray?
Oh my goodness, mercy.
Ray? Ray?
Ray?
It ain't captured. Ray. Ray.
I know, can you imagine? Oh!
You gotta let go. Oh, take it off, take his belt off.
Oh no, he's gonna get pulled in.
Oh, it's gonna go in. Oh, I have
to go for a swim.
Gross.
Social security or income tax or nothing, which you're really not supposed to do, you see, but for the purpose.
It's gonna be a smart baby.
My god, there, yeah.
Great place.
Oh, he's doing so good.
I bored him to sleep.
Motherhood's a very natural instinct.
Like, we said so. Whoa!
No way.
Pull forward. Ew! Oh, he looks like how he was before possessed.
Look at him. I am Zool.
Zool.
No, no, nobody called.
Look at his lips to call.
You're right, let's stay.
Oh my god, look at
no!
him. You can't do right there, right now. Whoa. Oh boy.
Standing.
Oh
my god. Oh, luckily the ledge is wider.
Oh.
Oh god, it does look like him.
Oh my god.
Ooh.
Oh my god.
Ooh, it looks like blood now.
Oh boy.
The evil is coming.
Ooh, it's actually going up.
Wow. See him. Yeah?
Will be the mother of the ruler of the world. Doesn't that sound nice?
No. Oh, I like scary. His character. It is.
Yes,
so
it sounds scary.
You're not going to take my baby.
Whoa.
I think they have other plans.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. Oh, boy.
Your shoes. Ooh! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Ah,
he says the Titanic just arrived.
Oh no!
Oh god, no. Whoa! Oh. I guess it's
Cheech.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Ooh!
He's taking over the whole city.
Ooh!
Oh my god, yeah.
Yeah, it's getting
big. We need something that everyone in this town can get behind. We need.
Lady Liberty.
Liberty!
Oh. Yeah.
Whether she's naked under that toga.
Oh, chase, leave it him. Of course.
Yeah, clean all that up after.
Oh my gosh.
That's Nintendo!
It's almost midnight. Let's go, Vink.
That's a cool effect right there.
Yes, okay.
That looks really realistic. It looks believable. Oh, ooh. Hey. It's Spangler with Egon's. And make out. Oh,
that's
so natural. They actually have borders like a parade.
That's funny. Oh my god.
Oh, oh, oh! No one's in there, hopefully.
Sorry, Gumper!
Oh, Slimer!
Oh, Slimer's there.
Okay.
Come on.
I didn't know you had your license.
He's going on! No.
Oh, no. Oh. Oh, 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 what the heck is that?
Honey.
A snakey snake.
Ooh.
Pipey snake. Ooh, we got out.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh,
in flesh.
Oh, boy. Oh, no.
Ooh.
Hello.
Ooh, that's never happened.
Oh. It's baby. Ah, oh, shoot.
Ooh.
Whoa. Whoa.
Electrocute him.
Oh, no. Oh, that poor baby. Oh, God.
Don't drop the baby. Yeah. Oh, good. Good catch. God.
Yeah.
Don't get close, Ray.
Oh, my gosh, don't. Ray, come on.
Look at his face.
Oh, no, Ray.
Oh no! Oh, both at the same time. Oh, yeah. Oh, good job, Louis.
Self-cleaning.
Yeah, I know, self-cleaning.
Yeah,
go up into space.
Louis thinks he did
everything. Oh, 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 oh. Like, hey, my mommy. Oh my god!
Oh, my god.
I love it.
Oh.
How'd they get it back? Nice. You're just walking back over there?
I know! To get it exactly in the same pose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I was hoping she'd have a smile on her. That would have been funny. Yeah. I really thought that was going to be a thing. You gotta love the music, too. We have to watch...
Lady Liberty.
Yeah, that was great. Yes. We have to watch the old Ninja Turtle movies at some point, because this music reminds me a lot of it.
Yeah. Well, it's 80s music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, what'd you guys think?
I liked it a lot.
It was a favorite.
Entertainment.
It was very entertaining for sure. We were laughing a lot. And it did have a lot of like suspense to it. And I love how creepy it was, too. It was actually very scary considering the time it came out. Like, I thought it would be a little bit cheesy, but the first one was really good, too. But this one, like, had, I don't know, like, the painting was
especially
very
down below and the river of slime.
Oh, that was great. Yes, that was really.
It's interesting.
I wouldn't go underneath the cities of New York.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
When they first went down there and they actually made that hole in the street, I was like, can't they find, like, an entrance somewhere like they did the second time? But I guess they were just so excited they wanted to go right there. All that commotion and having the cops show up. And,
yeah, I was
but it
gonna
was
say,
funny that way.
Yeah.
And it's funny how Ray always has to go in first. I
yeah,
think that happened
Ray.
In the first one,
yes,
too.
He's the chosen one.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was definitely entertaining. I like this movie.
That's good.
When they went back on the railroad tracks with Winston and the train.
Oh, my
goodness.
Yeah.
Poor Winston.
Sorry.
Yes. I am happy he was in this more. That was cool that he was in this one more because he was, I mean, they were learning the business, the first movie, and then Winston was an extra later on, but he did do a lot, but he wasn't like fully involved until later in the movie.
Yeah.
And then this one, he had a bigger role, which was nice.
Uh-huh.
And
I liked it a lot.
Yeah. And I like how Egon and Ray were nerding together all the time. Like they both love science, and they're both geeking out over the same stuff. Yeah, and it's just so weird.
Oh,
like that whole conversation earlier when Peter was like, what do you guys do? Do you sleep with it? Or who said that? Winston or Peter or something? And how
and
they
Peter
let that go. I'm like, no freaking way. I'm like, I like that talking about it. And I'm like, what? So I don't recall a lot of this movie. I do know some stuff. Like, I knew the Statue of Liberty was involved. I remember there being a pink slime. The painting, I remember a scene, but there were a lot of scenes like that where we were just looking at the creepy still picture, that painting, like, just glaring. And I think one of the parts where it was ghosting over and coming out of the painting,
that's
what freaked me out as a child.
Oh, at the beginning?
Yes.
That was
yeah, that scared the
I
crap out of me.
I got freaked out this time.
It was like, woo, you know? So I think it was definitely enjoyable. Like, yes, it's dated, but for the time, the special effects were actually really cool.
My gosh.
It really worked well, you know?
I loved the beginning where they showed people being more rude than you would expect to be.
Oh, yeah.
Street, like bumping into the lady with the crutches and not really helping Dana with the baby.
Yeah, a couple of them did, but yeah, like, I was shocked with the lady on the crutches and the guy just knocks into her and just keeps running. I'm like, holy
That's
crap,
right,
she could have
God.
Really got hurt, and you just would be like, I get people get rude and they bump into each other, but if you're walking normal, not injured, you're not elderly, not like, not that it's an excuse, but usually that's like, we're normal.
Yeah.
But with someone injured like that, so that was kind of progressing to this whole part with the ooze getting created because there's so much hate and anger.
Negative. Yeah.
Yeah. And I love how they make fun of New York, because New York is wonderful and they do have a lot of fun personalities. You know, you have great people, of course, and then you
it's
have
all diversified,
like,
don't
forget. And there's a lot of anger there too, but I love how they say it with love, you know, like, oh, it is New York. But it's a good message to show that people do get really angry and we have to be more positive about things. So it was a good message, I thought.
And what a great ending to have it on New Year's Eve.
That's
everyone's so happy.
And happy and singing.
It was
and I love how they brought in Statue of Liberty. And for some reason, I thought she was the bad guy going to be, which would be bad, I know, because she's representing something good, you know. But I thought she was going to be like the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man and come back.
Like,
again.
He's going to take over her.
Yeah. So it wasn't an exact repeat, which was nice. It was an actual, like, new idea that the Ghostbusters themselves decided to do that to bring out the positive side of everyone, to come together as a unit, you know? So I love how they had full control over the statue, because I'm like, this thing's big. It's very important, first of all, for them to get the okay, or for people to be okay, you know, afterwards, was really funny, but it worked well. I like how they made it like a parade. And her torch was lit, actually you know?
Yes.
And she's following what the Ghostbusters are saying, and she actually breaks into the museum for that. But then she's laying on the freaking ground after. I thought, like, she would at least be standing there, you know, instead of, like, face-planting the ground. I was like, oh, no. So it was kind of funny. Geez. But that whole scene I really did enjoy, though, blaring the music and waving to the crowd.
And it really got the people in the city and on the streets really happy. And it led up to the New Year's Eve tune.
Oh, goodness, yes.
Yeah.
I like that.
I love Lewis at the end, though, when he thinks that he opened up the building.
I love
Lewis.
Lewis
is awesome.
Yes. He's so funny.
He is so funny. And
I like him.
We were recently saying off camera that something really bad happened to him. He was sucker punched or something, right?
Oh,
like,
yeah,
people
just
suck.
He got sucker punched.
Yeah, I don't know the whole story, but someone just went up to him and I guess punched him.
He was just crossing somebody on the street, and he just got sucker punched. And
I wonder if they knew who he was.
Horrible.
Not that it matters, I guess, because, like, you shouldn't do that to anyone.
I don't think he did. I don't think they knew who he was.
Yeah, that's so messed up. What's wrong
with
people?
And
it's like, we really like this guy,
and
too.
Unfortunately, he was in New York City, right?
Yes.
And he just came back out of retirement to do a commercial, too.
Oh,
really?
Gosh. Wow. Yeah.
See,
something.
I mean, it could happen to anyone, but when you're an actor, too, like, people just see you as a certain way sometimes, and people will just target and do something, and it just sucks sometimes. Because I hear these stories from certain actors that, you know, whether you play a good person or a bad person or both, like, people just have to mess with you in some way.
Plus, he was Dark Helmet. How can you punch Dark Helmet?
I know! I love that movie.
I like Lewis with Janine. That was fun.
That was funny.
That was great.
That was really
That was perfect. And it was really funny, too, with the commercial, Kim, because you were asking when they were doing that real cheesy commercial for the Ghostbusters, and you were like, are they together or something? I'm like, no, I don't think so, but who knows? I kind of wonder. I'm like, are they going to get together in this one? So, I mean, like, it's stereotyping a bit because they're both kind of nerdy and whatnot and geeky, but it was just funny how they put them together. But it worked out well, and I love
it
so much.
It was perfect. I'm glad he was working for them.
Well, like how we changed the voice in the crosswalk. Like,
oh, I know.
It's
so, like, strange, but it's so cute.
The look on his eyes when they're talking and he jumps back on her.
It's like so exaggerated too. Janine was very forward. I didn't expect
that,
but with her personality, I can kind of see that. Yeah, but at that time I couldn't. It was like, whoa, like full on leg over him. Like, hey, he's like looking at her crystal ball.
Whoa.
So, and I know you're not supposed to overthink it like that, but here they're babysitting this kid, and it's like, oh yeah, come on over. Although that wasn't the initial agreement, so I'm happy Dana was okay with it. But she was questioning him before. more. She's like,
well, she was trying to kick him out too, and they just wouldn't leave.
I know, and then they just started up again. Like, it's okay. It's not really her place, anyways, right? No. It was Peter's place.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah, that was funny. But I do like the friendships in this, and
yeah,
it worked out well. Yeah. You know, Dana was awesome. And how did you feel about Dana actually marrying a different guy? Did you think that was Peter's baby in the beginning?
I did think it was Peter's baby.
I thought so too.
And then when she was questioning Egon about him, I thought they broke up and they were divorced, or they just split up.
Yeah.
And she was just inquiring, like, she still liked him. She looked like she still was intrigued with him.
Yeah, I thought so too, because I didn't realize, you know, she was married before.
Yeah.
So I thought
See,
it was
and
safe.
That's how I felt too, because I was like, oh no, because I really wanted them to be together. And I thought maybe they broke up, and same thing, Kim. I'm glad now they're together. I don't think there's a Ghostbusters 3. I think it jumps to the one with a girl cast or ladies cast. But I hope they stay together, you know. But I was a little sad to know that wasn't his baby, because I thought the same thing. I was like, oh man.
Yeah.
And Tom knows. He's like, I already know. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
so,
like,
how'd you feel, if you remember? How did you feel?
Oh, I can't remember, but I kind of figured it wasn't his baby.
Yeah.
Only just because of the way, you know, you don't see him right away, Peter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And just the way she's walking, she's still living by herself, as far as you know.
Yeah.
And it was 5 years later from the first movie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's true.
I like how they established that right away. And when she rolled the carriage over the slime, like, how scary is that? Because I thought of mom right away. Because once there's a baby, of course, we all care, but any child endangerment, like, mom gets so freaked out by it. And yeah, I mean, I heard you too, Kimmy, like, freaking out. But it is, it's scary.
Yeah.
And what a great way to show, like, start a movie, because now you're seeing, like, holy crap, like, this kid's in danger. What's going to happen? And God forbid, like, something actually bad happens.
Well,
but
if anybody's ever driven in New York, you know how those they drive in the city.
Yeah.
So I've seen the stroller going through the streets.
Oh, that's scary.
It's scary, kind of scary. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, all the time, because even in Philly, because I went to school in Philly, I mean, it wasn't as extreme, I guess. I mean, it depends on what location you're in. Sometimes, like, walking across the street, like, a taxi would almost hit you. Someone would almost hit you. And someone would always hit a hood and be like, hey, F you, get off, whatever. Like, just natural everyday occurrences. It's like, holy crap. Like, people are just crazy drivers, you know? People just need to get to where they're going. They don't care. It's like, you're on the street. Watch out. But that was scary. And to have this slime take over everyday objects, like, everything's at risk.
I love the court scene when they were getting in trouble. I was like, guys, you got the slime right on the table.
That's
And I love the way the judge was like, please help me, please help me.
I know, because that was strange too. Where it's like, okay, we're seeing this ooze. We know something bad's going
to
happen.
Yes.
Yeah, and I like how anger brought it out. Like, it got really animated after that, you know? Yeah, I can't remember what I thought originally, but I think I thought it wasn't emotions. I thought it was just vibrations that triggered it. But I love the idea that it was emotions.
Emotions, yeah.
Again, a positive message, which is a good thing.
Oh, I just love Lewis. I think Lewis should just stay as an accountant. Don't
do anything. Yes, okay, I was giving tax advice about the seven dwarfs and everything.
Oh, I love that
too. That kid went to sleep.
That was perfect. He was more into babysitting than Janine. I mean, Janine was good too, don't get me wrong, but, like, that was so funny. He was so good at, like, for the baby. That was good. I do really enjoy Peter's character a lot. Like, he's so confident and I don't know, like,
really...
he is entertaining. And it's funny how things don't faze him. Like, he really cares for Dana. But even in the first movie, when she was possessed, he was still playful and teasing her. It felt like he was like, holy crap,
gosh,
my girlfriend or possible girlfriend that I really like is messed up right now and roaring and flying or floating above her bed.
Just a fun fact. Did you know that Jim Belushi was actually supposed to be in the Ghostbusters as one of the Ghostbusters?
Oh, yeah.
No, I did not know that.
Oh, that would have... That would have made sense.
Really?
He was good friends with Dan Aykroyd.
And Egon.
Egon
was a writer for SNL.
Right.
Was he?
Oh, yeah.
See, this is so fun. I love you guys, like, saying stuff. Oh, that's cool. Wow.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Jim Belushi passed before they even started shooting for Ghostbusters 1.
Yeah.
Okay,
so they went with...
And Dan Aykroyd, I mean, they were the Blues Brothers, too.
Right.
Exactly. I never saw that. Everyone goes quiet. Ooh. That's really cool. No, I didn't know that. Yeah, see? It was like, come on. They're going to put that on the request now. We're going to have to put that on the list.
Was I trying to high-five the camera?
High-five the camera!
Get your sandwich out.
Yeah. So a part that really stood out to me was, again, with the painting, when you saw the face really come out.
Oh, like, that was really, yeah.
I really enjoyed that character, Viggo. I'm just glad that of all the other things, because the slime was the main thing that was coming out because of all this anger and negative responses and emotions. So how many other things just in the city could get possessed? So I liked how Viggo was the main guy, but how we kept seeing these other ghosts popping out of random places, too, that were getting triggered by the slime. So it wasn't just him,
right,
but he was
the
like
negativity.
The ultimate evil at the moment. Yeah. Yeah.
Right, like the courtroom with the twin, with the brothers that
the judge
put away. Yes. Like they came out. So different areas, these ghosts were coming out.
Yeah.
Viggo's Patsy Yonish.
What's that?
Viggo's Patsy Yonish, how creepy and funny he
was.
Oh,
he was
great.
I loved his character
really
so much.
He was obsessed with Dana, almost like Lewis was before.
That's true, yeah.
He was just a
neighbor.
He was just a big creeper.
That is so true. That was so funny, too, because I have to say, I love the ghosts because they are so exaggerated, just like the first movie, but they're not just people, like, oh, people who passed away. Like, they were saying benches and random objects come to life. And even as a human dying and coming back as a ghost, like, you look like a cartoon character, you know?
Right.
Like, their features are super exaggerated. And then they had a gargoyle-type looking one with, like, multiple arms and eyes and a beak. And so it's just out there, but I love it because...
fur coat.
Yeah, I know, that was great because it was dead animals, and it's like, of course you're going to come back.
That's right.
Get you for it. And
that's...
this is faux fur, guys, just saying.
And Slimer was a bus driver.
He was in it quite a lot. I wasn't sure you were going
to
show him again.
He used to where he needed to go, so he must have done something right.
Yeah. I know, so I'm happy about that because I really thought that that was the end of Lewis. Not that he was going to die, but I didn't think he'd be able to show up because he crashed somewhere, you know? But how funny. He's so innocent in that way. He was so happy to put on the suit, and then he goes on the bus.
She was zipping him up.
Yeah, and then he's like, oh, okay, well, I hope you have your driver's license. He goes on. Anyways, because I guess he's just desperate to get there. So
it is
perfect.
Oh,
but actually, you know what? My favorite scene, of course, is the Statue of Liberty, like I said before. That really stood out to me as well. But the creepiness, like that face of that scary Viggo guy was woo. But
he's just a creepy dude just in general.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't have to look like an orc at the end.
I would have to cross over it every night. Okay.
Yeah, and also the baby on the ledge. Of the building.
Ooh,
oh, yeah.
Yes.
That was scary. It was really
that was very scary.
Ooh. It was good that Lewis and Janine were there with Dana.
Right,
you know,
to actually
they wouldn't leave.
Call 911 because she immediately went on the ledge, and I get it. Like, she's the mother and she wants to protect her baby, and the baby could fall at any moment.
Ooh,
and
standing
by itself, you know? So
complete control.
Yeah, it was just
as far as we know, he never knew how to stand by himself.
So it looked even weirder to see that, you know. So I know it's not as scary as that because you have a human child there, but it reminds me of a story in college when I had Shoshomaru, my cat, and she was only 1 year old. My roommate left her window open and we didn't have any screens on our windows, and we were on the third story. So Moo went missing and we couldn't find her around feeding time. She always comes to eat. So I actually looked out the window and she's all the way down on the edge, like the baby was standing right at the edge, and the ledge was smaller, but it's a cat, so they balance.
Oh, how did you know
this? You couldn't reach her because she was all the way on the other side of the apartment building. And I was like, so I'm trying not to freak out, and the wind's coming up, you know, but your car's going by. You don't see people on the street right now, so I'm like, any distraction, she might fall. I'm like, oh, my God. So I'm like, Shoshomaru. So I grabbed a bag of treats, and I'm like, come here, come here. And then she slowly turned around. No problem. Not scared. Came right back, and I just grabbed her. And I'm like, guys, don't open a window without a screen on it, because we had, like, a couple windows without screens on them. And I'm like, don't do that with a cat in the house, you know, in the city. But thank God she didn't fall. But again, cats land on their feet, and they say certain heights. But again, the street was right there when cars go.
That's right. It's two stories up.
It's big. But a baby, I know, is very scary. It's different. But still, she's my fur baby, and I'm glad she was okay there. But wow, like things you don't think of. And it's like, I also had my window open with my main door shut, so the cat couldn't get inside my room at the time when I was working on a project, and a pigeon actually flew inside and actually sat, like, I was sitting right next to the windowsill, and these windowsills were, like, pretty deep inside, so he jumped right next to me, literally, beak almost touching my shoulder, and went, ooh, like that. And I went, I didn't know what to do because I'm like, is it going to peck me? What's it going to do? And then it just flew away. It came in, it cooed at me, and then it just flew away. And I was like, okay, so I need a screen on this window too.
It's probably gone in other windows too.
Probably because it wasn't fazed by me being there. Yeah, I was like, yeah. I was like, hey, what's up? Got something for me? Nope. All right, bye. Like, not even freaked out. And I was like, all right, what do we do?
It's a city bird. Oh
my yeah. God, but used to it. Going back to, yeah, right. And going back to Dina, like, I knew that the ghost was going to get the baby somehow. And I'm like, how is this going to happen? So you think. You think he's protected. He's in a bedroom. Everything's closed. I guess the window wasn't locked, but either way, maybe the ghost could just
open it. Open too.
Yeah, because the ghost opened up the window. And I'm like, ooh, that's freaky. You don't even think that. And I love how her instincts kicked in. I don't know if she heard a rush in a wind or something, but she actually, like, slowly looked like something's wrong and went to go check
up on
him. Yeah, because
there was a little wind behind
her. Yeah,
she
saw, yeah, you saw the her hair moving.
Mm-hmm. I love how they kept doing that. Like, every time a ghost was present or something, like, all the wind would start up, even inside the courtroom. It was like, woo, they stopped talking.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
So, ooh, there you go again. Sorry, guys. So, who was your favorite Ghostbuster? And
oh,
this one.
God, me...
Lewis.
Yeah. Lewis.
Lewis.
Yeah.
Lewis. Yeah.
Lewis.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm going to say going. Ray this time.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's been through a lot.
Yeah.
In this movie.
Yeah.
He's just so serious when he has something. And Egon is great too when he's so serious. But Ray.
Ray has always been my favorite, him and Egon, but watching this one, I'm like, you know what? I really do like Winston too. He's adorable. I can see myself more like him, you know? Yeah. Like, he is trying to
dress. He brought in the fire extinguisher.
That's right.
He was so good
that
way.
Yeah.
Yeah, he saved them. He acted so quick.
Yeah, that was pajamas too.
Oh, I know. That's totally me too. I would totally wear some crazy pajamas. But I like it because they're so passionate about their work that they have to take off all their clothes because of the angry, you know, sludge all over them. And they just run into a restaurant because they're so excited in their PJs in a fancy restaurant. And they know they're going to get in trouble.
Well.
And they have to talk to Peter.
Yeah.
So just, I love that about them,
goodness,
you know, how much they enjoy their job.
About their work.
Good.
And they struggle a lot too. Like, they don't get money, like good money. They just get enough to get by. But they're so passionate about it, the science behind it and the mystery behind it. And
well,
I want to say magic.
They have their
but
own department now in New York City.
Well,
yeah.
Yeah,
if you remember from the first movie how much they were charging that hotel for that to get Slimer.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just to get the finances.
Yeah.
So now they have to do that all the time, probably until they get enough work, but that means there's a whole lot of ghosts out there. So, guys, I am having technical difficulties. I sound normal to myself, but to you guys, I sound like a demon or very slow motion. So, very good movie. Happy Halloween. Hopefully you can hear me okay.
Really.
We're dying here. So, thank you guys so much for watching. And we'll see you very soon as always. Bye, guys.
Bye, Vigo.
Bye, Vigo, yeah.
Bye, Vigo. Man, so hopefully.
Oh my God, that was so funny, John.
That is so funny. I'm happy it didn't happen until the end.
You're so serious. Okay, I'm gonna shut everyone down.
You do sound like Shaq's wife and Hubie.
Yeah, you do.
Oh yeah. That's great.